And also, how do you resolve the issue of ma'murat and mahdhurat regarding the hadith of the companion who asked during the khutbah of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when a particular verse was revealed and it was said to him that you have benefited nothing from this except for your leghu? If the person did not know, he was ignorant of the ruling on not speaking during the khutbah.
Okay, I'll answer inshallah. Now, Mukhtar was entitled for one question, but he diplomatically squeezed a second question in it. So I have all the right not to answer. And I will answer, but I don't know of such a hadith where a companion during the khutbah asked about an ayah, and the Prophet, he said to him, you did not benefit anything except lahu, idle talk that maybe ruined your khutbah. I don't know of any such hadith. And speaking during the khutbah is totally prohibited except with the imam. So we have a number of hadiths where the Prophet ﷺ either initiates talking with one of the followers during the khutbah, as in the hadith of Salik al-Ghatafani, when he came and sat down during the khutbah. So the Prophet interrupted alayhi salatu wasalam his speech and said to him, did you pray two rak'ahs? He said, no. He said, stand up and pray two rak'ahs. And also in hadith of Anas, may Allah be pleased with him, when while the Prophet was giving khutbah of Friday, a man came and at the door, a nomad, he started complaining that the drought has struck their areas and the livestock is dying because of that drought and famine. So ask Allah for us for rain. So the Prophet ﷺ interrupted his khutbah and started making dua to Allah for rain, and it rained. He didn't say that your prayer is invalid or you have committed a sin, or etc. Nothing. So scholars say that speaking to the imam for a legitimate reason, there is nothing wrong in it. Therefore, I cannot, Mukhtar, comment on your question, because I have to have the original hadith in Arabic so that I can check it and verify whether it's authentic or not.